So here we have our two experiment tanks.
It's another 1500 grams.
What's going on, guys? Welcome to another video. Hope you're doing well. Super excited today because we're going to start with the first experiment of the Twinscape project. Just a little recap. About 2 weeks ago, I showed you guys this video where I announced that I would like to start a new series with two exactly the same tanks and do some experiments. And in that video, I asked you guys to come up with the kind of experiments that we can do. And the comments on that video went absolutely insane. I think we have over 200 comments or something. So thank you all for all your creative ideas. I really liked it. So basically, like a week later, I went through all the comments and checked which ones were commented the most, which one was the most popular, which was CO2 versus no CO2, aquasol versus dirt, and lean dosing versus EI dosing. So from those three comments, from those three answers, I made a poll so everybody could vote on that. I thought that would be the most fair. I have the poll right here. Let me check. So 1400 people voted on that poll, which is absolutely insane. And 55% chose CO2 versus no CO2. So that's what we're gonna start with. And then 26% chose aquasol versus dirt. So that will be the second experiment. And 19% chose lean dosing versus EI dosing. So that will be the third experiment. So we're just gonna go through the list. So yeah, today we're starting with the first experiment. We're gonna set up two exactly the same tanks with the same equipment, same hardscape, the same plants, same substrate. But one is gonna have CO2 injection and the other one is not gonna have any CO2 injection. So I'm super excited to see the results. I was quite surprised that there was so much interest into this topic because it has been done before in the past by some people. But I think it's always a good thing to bring up this topic again and show the differences. So yeah, I think let's just get started.
So here we have our two experiment tanks. We have two 20 liter or 5 gallons OptiQuiet rimless tanks, both running a Jihiro's A-series LED light. So I'm thinking to just start with the scaping progress. Just start with the hardscape, start with the planting, fill them both up. And once we're done with that, we can talk about the details of this experiment. How long we're gonna keep it running for, how we're gonna go about this experiment, and what kind of results we should be expecting.
Okay, so the substrate for this experiment is gonna be aquasol, basically for a few reasons. I always use aquasol in my aquascapes. It's what I feel the most comfortable with. That's reason number one. I think reason number two is, I think aquasol will also give the aquarium without CO2 the best chance of succeeding. And reason number three is aquasol already has nutrients in it. I'm thinking for this experiment to not use any liquid fertilizer because I think that will just make things more complicated because do you give both tanks the same amount of liquid fertilizer? Of course, a tank with CO2 is gonna need more liquid fertilizer than a tank without CO2. But is that gonna compromise the results? So I'm thinking no liquid fertilizer, just the nutrients from the aquasol. I do want to make sure that both tanks get the exact same amount of aquasol. Before we add the substrate, I want to make sure we weigh it so both tanks get equal amounts. So I reckon we're going to need about 3-4 kilos of soil per aquarium. So let's start with 3 kilos and then see if that's enough or we're going to need to add some more. Right, so that's 1500 grams. So let's go in with the first bowl. It's another 1500 grams. I think that's actually enough. So that's 3 kilos in. I think that's a perfect amount for this 20 liter tank. So let's add 3 kilos to that one as well. I'm not gonna use any root taps, by the way, just to not make it any more complicated for ourselves because some plants might have better access to those root taps and start growing better and other plants might not have access. So let's stick to just simple aquasol, nothing else. All right, so that's 3 kilos of aquasol in each tank. And the aquasol that I went with is, by the way,
Neosoil from Aquario. Really good stuff. I've used this as well in my 70 liter Skipper's tank with great results. I would say it's very similar to ADA Amazonia or Tropica soil. Very rich in nutrients, so yeah, we shouldn't need any liquid fertilizers for quite a while with these two tanks. So next step is the hardscape. Of course, you know, this experiment is about the plants and how the plants are going to grow with CO2 and without CO2. But I also want to make these tanks look nice. I don't want to have two plant growing farms in my house here. I also want them to look nice, so we're going to add some hardscape as well. And these are, you know, this is called a twinscape experiment, so we need to make sure that these two tanks look very similar. Yeah, it's called a twinscape project for a reason. So we're going to have two identical tanks, and that also goes for the hardscape. So I had already some hardscape selected. We're going to use a few pieces of black spider wood, and we're going to use some mini landscape rocks. So three rocks for each cape and two pieces of wood for each cape. So let's see if we can come up with a nice hardscape composition just to make these tanks, these experiment tanks, look like actual aquascapes. Alright, that's the first hardscape complete. Super simple, took like 5 minutes or so. Yeah, just three rocks, one big one, one medium size, then one small one, and two pieces of wood, and that's it. I like it, it's clean, and for this project it's perfect. So let's see if we can create something that looks similar in this tank. That's it, that's the best thing I could do in trying to make these two look identical. But they look sort of similar, right? Yeah, trying to replicate something with different shaped materials is not so easy. Next step is to secure the wood to the rocks just to make sure it doesn't float. For that, I like to use some liquid super glue together with some paper towels. Just take small bits of paper towel and wedge them in between the two points where the wood is touching the rock. Add a little bit of super glue on top of it. And within seconds, it's rock solid and secure. Alright, so as you can see, I glued one over there, one in the back there, and one in the back over there, and one over there. So like 5 or 6 points, and now it's completely stuck. It doesn't move anymore. So we'll spend a little bit of effort trying to glue it properly and just save a lot of headache. Obviously all those white spots of kitchen paper sticking out, it doesn't really look very nice. But we can easily cover that up later with some moss or some other plants. Alright guys, the hardscape is in place, so I think it's ready for planting. Got a really nice selection of plants. These are pretty much all easy category plants. I think that's important with our experiment. So as always, the plants are sponsored by Denola Plants, so huge shout out to them. I'll leave the link to their website in the description box below. Do check that out. They have a lovely website full of inspiration and a lot of information about plants as well. So definitely check that out. All right, so let's take a quick look at all the plants that I chose for this project. Starting with in vitro, I got here Marsalea hirsuta. So this is like a really easy carpeting plant. And I've actually had great success with this in a low-tech environment as well. So this should do well. Next up, we have Heteranthera zostrifolia. Never actually used this plant, I think, in my scapes, but it's like easy, fast growing plant as well. I think it's good for the mid ground or the background. Of course, we can't do without Monte Carlo. This is another easy carpeting plant. So we'll mix this up together with the Marsalea just to get a nice mixed carpet. Then next one is a medium category actually. Well, I'm not sure about this one because on the Denola website it says easy category. But this is Hygrophila araguaia. And it's quite an easy plant, so it should do well even without CO2. Then we have some moss. This is Vesicularia ferreri. Basically, this is called weeping moss. I have two of those. And then next up, the potted plants. This is a plant that I've actually never used before as well. Micranthemum umbrosum. This is a medium category. So yeah, this is like a very small stem plant. Looks a little bit like Monte Carlo, but then this one should grow upright. And then we have another stem plant. In the easy category, we have Rotala rotundifolia orange juice. So to give a bit more color in this cape, we're gonna have an orange stem plant. And lastly, we have Ludwigia repens. This one is labeled as medium, but in my opinion, this is a very easy plant as well. So that's our plant selection. So I'm gonna prepare all these plants quickly and then we can start planting. Okay, shout out to Yuris for the planting map idea. But the planting map is really, yeah, just a great way to give you a bit more of a visual idea of what you want to do with planting wise. So here in the foreground, we're going to have a mixed carpet of Monte Carlo and Marsalea. Then in the midground, we're going to have the Hygrophila araguaia, the weeping moss on all the hardscape. And on the right side, we're going to have Micranthemum umbrosum. In the background, we're going to have the Heteranthera zostrifolia. And all the way in the back, it's going to be, you can't see it. All the way in the back, we're going to have the Rotala orange juice. And in the right side, we're going to have the Ludwigia repens. So I removed all the plants from the pots. We can divide them into portions now. Stem plants like this, I would never just plant them like this because it's kind of looks silly. I will probably just snip them in half, cut them in half and plant both the bottom and the top part. So it's much lower, but then they can start growing and start changing to their submerged form. I'll probably do the same with the Rotala orange juice. Right, one down and one to go. I could probably plant a little bit more densely with the carpet, but I just want to make sure I have enough still for the second one. So once the second one is done and we'll have some plant leftovers, I can always add them in between. We just need to make sure that both tanks have all roughly the same amount of plants going in from the start. So let's continue with number two. Alright guys, our two twinscapes are ready for our experiment. So the tank on the left here is equipped with CO2. It's on a timer from 11:30 till 8. And the tank on the right doesn't have any CO2 at all. So let's see what's going to happen. Let's see how big the differences will be.
So the plan right now is to do daily water changes on both tanks for the first week. Especially with this type of aquasol, it's releasing quite a lot of nutrients. So during the first week, I'll do daily water changes. During the second week, I'll do water change every other day, and so on, until we're at just one water change per week. I'm also not going to dose any liquid fertilizer, especially not in the first month. And I'm also keeping the light intensity the same for both tanks. So both lights are on a timer from 1 o'clock till 9 o'clock. So about 8 hours, and I'm keeping the intensity at about 75%. I think 75% is good. It's strong enough to get decent plant growth, but it's not too strong for a low-tech tank to turn into an algae soup. I've also added some floating plants just to help with soaking up those excess nutrients and also to diffuse the light a little bit more. So I'm curious when we will start seeing some changes and some differences in these two tanks. So guys, let me know in the comments what you want me to pay attention to, what you want me to document. Of course, the most obvious thing is going to be the differences in plant growth, but also algae growth. I think we're going to see lots of changes in there, lots of differences. I was thinking overall plant health and also plant color, especially with the red in the Ludwigia and the orange in the Rotala. So yeah, it's going to be an interesting one. We also need to decide how long we're going to keep this experiment running for. I'm thinking maybe 2 months, something like that, maybe even longer. And we also need to decide if we're going to add livestock to these two tanks. So lots of things to consider. And also, you guys need to make sure you smash that like button, because when you do, when this video gets more likes, and the YouTube algorithm will show it to more people, so more people can watch our experiment. So lots of things to look forward to. I'm super excited. Hope you guys are as well. I'll keep you posted. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.